can be. The sweet love story that is older than the sea. The simple truth about the love she brings to me. Where do I start? With her first hello, she gave a meaning.
This is Linda Brown. She's a secretary working at the station master's office, and this is exactly how I met her. Living walking distance from the station, I had to get a train timetable for my sister. Unfortunately, not looking where I was going, I bumped into this lovely lady. I really wasn't looking where I was going. It's really stupid. The lady just looked at me and said nothing. The lady started to walk away, but I really wanted to know more about her. I offered to take her for a drink in the station cafe, but at last nodded her head in approval. In the cafe, sitting with our drinks, I tried to understand why she didn't talk. She looked into her bag and took out a small notebook and started to write. After reading her words, I then understood perfectly. It took a little time to find out where she lived. We sat for some time. I found Linda was divorced and lived with her little dog, Poppy. Before we left the cafe, I asked if I could see her again. To my amazement, she agreed. We stood and she shook my hand, and we agreed to meet on her next day off. We met and, along with Poppy, drove to the moors. The weather was just like Linda, wonderful. For me, a most enjoyable time. Throughout the following weeks, we became very fond of each other. I told Linda that I had had a heart problem, which left me with a slight limp, but this didn't seem to bother her. I also told her that my wife had passed away some 12 years ago. It had been a lonely time, which I knew it had also been for her. The walks on the moors, the coffee breaks overlooking the streams, and views were unforgettable. We found a little stone seat and just sat together. Linda was so lovely to look at. I was falling in love with this lady. Taking in the views before us, I turned to look at her lovely face. She too looked at me. We just hugged each other. We were in love. This particular day, I took my sister to the train after her visit. We had a lot to talk about, but what I didn't realise was that Linda had just returned from lunch and had seen myself and my sister talking and finally kissing goodbye. Linda must have been heartbroken. I just wish I had mentioned it to her. I just didn't think of it.
Come on, darling.
another time. She came into my life and made the living fine.
I made my way home when my mobile rang. It was my sister to say she was on the train and would call later. I stayed talking to her, but not realising that a car was driving towards me. He was getting closer and closer. I still didn't hear the car. I was so engrossed in the call from my sister. But then I heard this car horn, followed by a scream, then two more screams. I turned, only to realise the car was only feet away from knocking me over. Shaking badly, I looked up only to see Linda looking at me with a look of utter horror, followed by a slight smile. I went to Linda and hugged her and thanked her. Not only had she saved my life, but Linda had, through this incident, found her voice. Certainly, for me, a day to remember.